Once you're in Google Scholar, pop in the keywords that you've identified. Click on the search button, and the results you have looks like this. They're mostly journal articles, but you might have some books or conference proceedings, etc. Thing with Google Scholar, you get a lot of results. So I've got over 191,000. I can refine it on the left-hand side by custom date range. I'm going to go for the last 10 years. Click on search, and I'm down to over 17,000. I'm not going to include citations. What do I have? So on the right-hand side, I can access the full text. There's some PDFs and HTMLs. The entries themselves gives us the title of the article, author, the title of the journal, the year it was published. And underneath here, there's a little save button. And if you're logged into your Google account, you can save it into your account. There's a cite button, gives me the Harvard style, but you can tell it's not quite right, but you can copy and paste this into your Word doc. But I can tell already that date needs to be in round brackets and that full stop needs to be removed. But it's a great start for you. You can export also into EndNote here. Cited by 70. So you'll see each one says this one's cited by 48, this one's cited by 31. So it's how many times this single article has been cited by other articles. So if we click on that cited by 70, you'll see most of them are more recent. So this one's 2016, scroll down, got 2018. The original article, these 70 articles have that original article in their citations. They have used that. So you would have thought, the topic will be about the same. So a great way of finding relevant articles on your topic. Related articles is what it says on the tin. You click on this, it will take keywords from this one article here and find you other articles about the same thing. So a great way of finding other articles again. When you click on the title, it doesn't take you to the full text like it would in Google. It takes you to the publisher's website for that particular article. Now, this one recognizes I'm a Newcastle University member, so I can download the PDF. However, if it doesn't recognize you, go back to Google Scholar, go into settings, and go to library links. And if I type in Newcastle University and click on search, it gives me a couple of options. I want to click on the first one, Newcastle University, find at Newcastle, not the one in Australia, and click on save. And now you'll see on the right hand side, it looks a little bit different. So I've got the find at Newcastle link, I click on this, and it has linked up with our Newcastle University library search, library catalog. I can click on this. It will take me to the database that we subscribe to, and we can access and download the PDF. It might prompt you to put in your username and password. Just pop that in, and it will take you to the relevant database. So go back to Google Scholar. Great if you're off campus, working from home, and you want to link up Google Scholar to the library catalog. My warning, Google Scholar is wonderful. Just be careful though, don't just use Google Scholar. Use it in combination with library search and the databases. But it's a great way of finding full text for articles that we don't have, or scoping out your research, your assignment, see what's out there.